comes down to basic humanity. I feel that you need to make every single person feel valued and appreciated. And so coming at it from a place of kindness, you might not always understand everything, but if you can come at it with empathy and wanting to treat that person how you would want to be treated and to making everyone feel special, I think that's a great step. The next step is learning, is asking questions, researching and finding out what are the important steps you need to make change.
We really just want people to connect with us as people. I want them to see what we've gone through is not so much as a trans experience, but a human experience. And I think from that point, that's a starting point where people really start to develop understanding and empathy. And from that, growth comes.
I think one of the most important things for trans allies to keep in mind is that when it comes to pronouns, it's not just a matter of practicing pronouns, but it's also a matter of actually changing the way that you view that person. Because once you change your perspective and change your mind, pronouns kind of come as a much easier secondary thing.
Being a good ally means empathy and being able to really feel the person in front of you.
A statement that I think is really profound is that the absence of evidence is not the evidence of absence. And often through national data sets, research projects and policies, we're not counted appropriately and our needs aren't reflected. And that does not mean that we don't exist, and we need good trans allies to go a little further to ensure that we're at the table, that our voices are represented and that we're able to speak for ourselves, and that position is given to us